fancy riff that he does on the five here. He starts on the second string here on the G string. He slides up two frets on the G string. Hits the third fret on the B string. I think he does that three times. That's the tricky part. And he hits this note on the way down, but then immediately drops down to the five here. And then he starts into this riff here. I'm going to play those notes real slow. Up here. So that starts on the second fret on the A string. Play open on the D string. Walk up to the second fret. Then play it open. Down to the second fret on the A string. Walk down to the first fret. And here's where it gets tricky. Instead of going right to this note, he throws this in. Trouble getting my notes straight here. Let me try this one more time. Alright, so you go from here. Fret on the low string, back up to the A flat open, back to the third fret, up to the octave up E flat, alright, so you've put that together. All you have to do to close it out is do this little pattern here. So we're going to do the same thing we started here, except we're going to slide and hold it. Play open E flat. Then we walk up here. And put a little bit of wicked vibrato on the end there. Alright, so let's piece together what we've learned for this riff here. One was the opening sequence. And that takes us into the main riff where we got the chunk-a-chunk and the finger coming down, hitting the one note. We got the little chord accents there. Transition to the four. Transition back to the one. Then we got this riff here to take us to the 5. Then we have this little walk up and back down. And then the turnaround. So that's basically it. That's how he opens the song. And I'll do some lessons later on, you know, what he plays during while he's singing. But that, you know, if you can master that, I think you'll be set, because the rest of the song is a lot of this. And when he gets into the solo, and some live versions, he would throw in a regular shuffle. Actually, I think I'll teach that sometime. So he had ways of spicing up this pattern when he would get to the solos. I think later when he got Reese Winans into the band playing keyboards, he would take his time more and play more rhythm. But that should get you started with this song. One other note is that you're probably going to have to pick pretty hard to get that sound, because this is never going to sound the same as... And that's one little trick for you right there. For those of you who actually watched the whole way through, that's a bonus. When you get up to the 4 here, you can actually throw that chord in there. All right, have some fun with that.